What if there were a 6-bedroom, 2-bathroom house with a gym and a gorgeous view that cost $150 billion? You probably won't find that on Earth, but it does exist a little farther away. The International Space Station has more livable room than a 6-bedroom house. It also has a couple of toilets, a workout area, and a 360-degree view. Humanity's only permanent outpost in space is the most expensive object ever built. NASA has called it home for the last 2 decades, but the managers are planning on moving out, marking a new era in space.
Tonight, I am directing NASA to develop a permanently manned space station and to do it within a decade.
In 1984, President Ronald Reagan approved the construction of Freedom, but because of budget constraints, it was never built, and eventually the vision morphed into the ISS, the combined effort of 5 different agencies representing 15 different nations. In November 1998, the first component of the space station launched from Baikonur, Kazakhstan, on top of a Proton rocket. The Russian-built Zarya module wasn't alone for long.
Endeavour already traveling 575 miles per hour.
2 weeks later, the shuttle Endeavour carried the next module, Unity, the first American element built by Boeing. When Zarya and Unity joined together, that was the beginning of an engineering marvel. Dozens of launches over many years followed, building the station piece by piece by piece, fitting together tens of thousands of parts. The end result was a 109-meter-long structure the length of an American football field. Even though it often seems the ISS is gliding at a slow pace, it's actually moving at a speed of 17,500 miles per hour, so fast that it can circle the planet every 90 minutes. As of the making of this video, 240 people have visited the large spacecraft, living and working on what's really a giant floating laboratory, conducting research and science experiments that have led to many inventions. NASA's scratch-resistant helmets created scratch-resistant lenses. The rubber molding in those helmets is found in the soles of athletic shoes. The polymer fabric in spacesuits protects firefighters. Technology used to track astronauts' eyes is essential for laser eye surgery. NASA helped develop the first computer mouse, and the list goes on. But the main reason the ISS exists is to help humans learn about living and working in space in order to send us even farther. In 2018, President Trump signed a directive to focus on returning astronauts to the moon. It's been a while since we went there. The last time was in 1972. NASA created the Artemis program to send the first woman and next man to the lunar surface by 2024 using its Space Launch System, which will be the foundation for the agency's exploration beyond Earth's orbit. It's no coincidence Washington initially proposed ending NASA's funding for the space station the same year it wants to go to the moon, although funding could now be extended for a few more years. NASA spends between $3 to $4 billion to maintain and operate the ISS every year, money that could be used to support other projects. Its annual budget is about $19 billion, although the Trump administration has been increasing funding the last few years, providing nearly $23 billion in 2020. Even before President Trump came into office, the Obama administration tried to turn more of NASA's responsibilities over to the private sector.
And liftoff, the final liftoff of Atlantis.
When the agency retired its shuttle program in 2011, it decided not to build its own infrastructure to get to the ISS, but rather have its astronauts hitch a ride with commercial companies. NASA gave billion-dollar contracts to Boeing and SpaceX through its commercial crew program so they could build their own spacecraft.
Go NASA, go SpaceX, Godspeed, Bob and Doug.
Elon Musk's company won the race against Boeing when it sent 2 astronauts to the ISS aboard Crew Dragon in May 2020, which I talked about in another video. Boeing should have flown astronauts by now as well, but an uncrewed test flight in December 2019 didn't go as expected when the Starliner spacecraft went into the wrong orbit, so a crewed mission will have to wait until 2021. Opening up the ISS to private companies is also changing the way it looks. NASA gave the Texas startup Axiom a $140 million contract to build a segment that can be attached to the space station in 2024 and used for commercial business activities. When the ISS eventually retires, that component will detach and operate freely as a private space station. This is what one of the main living areas looks like. Axiom is also teaming up with SpaceX to fly three people to the space station in 2021. The price per seat is $55 million, and one is already taken. Hollywood is showing interest as well. Tom Cruise could board Crew Dragon to film a movie at the ISS. And Russia's state corporation Roscosmos is set to get back into the space tourism industry with flights to the ISS planned in the coming years. But private trips are out of reach for most people. Nor is this the main objective of these companies. It's a way of testing out technology in the pursuit of greater goals. SpaceX plans to circle the moon on a trip financed by Japanese billionaire Yusaku Maezawa, who will also take a group of artists with him in 2023. They'll be traveling on Starship, a fully reusable system currently in development. Starship will eventually be modified so that it can land on the moon. SpaceX is one of three companies selected by NASA to design a lunar landing system, competing against Jeff Bezos' Blue Origin and the relative newcomer Dynetics. This is the agency's first step toward creating a long-term presence on the moon, with the aim of leading to an even greater goal, Mars. NASA hopes to send humans to the Red Planet in the 2030s, but everything it wants to be able to do here, it must first do here. As the agency keeps its eyes on the moon and off the ISS, its partners appear to be doing the same. The European Space Agency is working ever more closely with China. In 2022, China aims to build its own space station and fly European astronauts. U.S. Congress banned Beijing from the ISS due to security concerns. And America's partner, Japan, is teaming up with India on a mission to the moon in order to counter the rise of China. While everyone's attention is turned elsewhere, the ISS is not getting any younger. Wear and tear on the 20-year-old structure means the end of its life will be sometime in the next decade. Going to the graveyard involves a controlled, destructive re-entry into Earth's atmosphere, just like this animation of the Russian space station Mir deorbiting in 2001. The ISS will burn up, break up, and vaporize into fragments, although some parts would survive and fall into a stretch of empty ocean in the South Pacific. The total weight of the debris is expected to be between 53,500 to 173,000 pounds, or as many as 32 Model Xs. Even when the ISS is no longer with us, it will be remembered not only as the most expensive man-made object ever built, not only as a triumph of international cooperation, but as a building block toward deeper missions in space. Without the International Space Station, a new era of space travel would not be possible.
Hey guys, I'm Cindy Pom. Thanks so much for watching. So what do you think about the ISS being opened up to commercial activity? Let me know your thoughts. You can leave them in the comments section below. If you like what you saw, give it a like and don't forget to subscribe to my new channel. A big shout out goes out to all my patrons, including my Patreon producer, Nino Johnny. I'll see you all very soon. Thank you.